Networking, security, and Wireshark.
So today I want to show you a really quick tutorial on how to actually measure the bandwidth or the bit rate that it takes to actually load a video on YouTube. Now this technique works for other streaming sites as well. I'm just using YouTube because that's my home platform. And I want to show you how to both measure the actual bit rate, so the actual bits needed to be transferred to your machine in order to load a video. But I also want to show you how to visualize that in a graph because it's actually useful to understand how streaming works. So before we get to actually loading up a sample video, what I want to do is actually open up Wireshark. And we're going to do a wide open capture. If you're not familiar with that, I will post a link to that video in the description. But I'm going to select the interface that's actually taking my traffic right now to the internet, which is the Ethernet interface. I'm going to double click. Make sure I see traffic going in both directions, which is good. This is my main PC, so there's other processes in the background right now that are generating this traffic, but what I will show you is how to easily pick out the YouTube video itself. Now, let's go back to YouTube. I'm going to pick a video to play. I'm just going to pick this three-hour rainy day vibes video. Now, YouTube, if you're not familiar, has a tool that you can use to actually look at statistics on bitrate and other technical statistics that you might want to see. You can right click and go to Stats for Nerds. Okay, and in this window, you can see there's a few different metrics that relate to network. So there's network activity, there is connection speed, and then there's the buffer health. Okay, so if you're not familiar with how streaming works on these sites, when they're downloading a video for you to play on your PC or on your, you know, smart device, they're buffering, meaning they're downloading pieces of the video ahead of time and then playing those back as the actual timestamp gets to that part of the video. That ensures that you have a good amount of data in queue in case you have like a network disruption. You can keep playing the video smoothly, and then whenever that network disruption goes away, your video will resume, okay? So that's what's depicted here. You can see here buffer health, which means how much data do I have in my buffer ahead. In this case, I have almost 100 seconds of video loaded on top of what I'm already seeing right now. So from this second here, I have 100 seconds plus. But you can also see the network activity. And network activity is pretty interesting because you can look at it, there's these little chunks. It's hard to see 100%, but these little chunks of network activity. And this is because of the way that YouTube downloads videos, is it downloads them in chunks, just like I mentioned, and then waits for a certain period of time, then downloads the next chunk. So this is all interesting to see. The part that I don't really like is this connection speed, because I don't really know how much, at any given time, how much data is being transferred in and out. So that's why we're going to go to Wireshark. So I'm going to leave this running. I'm going to open up Wireshark. Now, there's all sorts of data in a wide open capture, right? That I don't want to look at. What I want to look at is specifically my video traffic. If I just go to the bottom, I click this button here, automatically scroll, you can see there's traffic coming in and out of this machine constantly. So if I want to pick out just the conversation to YouTube, what I do is go to statistics and then conversations. Then I'm going to move this window up here. Now I want to look at IPv4 and I want to look at bytes. What I'm going to do is sort this by conversations with the greatest number of bytes as a way of me trying to find which conversation, meaning which source and destination pair, represents the connection to YouTube. Now this over here on the left is my IP. On the right are various other IPs that I'm connecting to. And if I just keep an eye on how the data is moving. Look, so for one, which one has the most data or close to the most data? And two, which one is external to my network? Then I can have a reasonable idea of which one is actually YouTube, provided there's nothing else going on in this machine. Like I'm not doing like torrenting in the background. And then you can do some educated guessing. So in this case, for example, I know that 192.168.1.104, this is a webcam I have in my network that I know this isn't YouTube, so I'm just gonna discount this one. But this one up here, you can see it's got 36 megabytes of traffic already. It's increasing constantly over time. It's got a long duration. I'm going to assume that this is my YouTube video. All right, so I'm going to right click on it, apply as filter, selected A and B. This selects or creates a filter for me in Wireshark that only looks at traffic between these two IP addresses. I'm going to apply it, and I'm just going to minimize this one. Now, you can see here that there's a lot of traffic between. There's some TCP traffic initially, and then when you get down here, you have UDP traffic, or specifically the QUIC protocol. Now, I'm not going to get into the details of this, but if you see QUIC, QUIC is a protocol that was designed by Google, which is used for this kind of application, downloading data, in this case, video data from Google's cache, okay? So I can, with some certainty now, considering the fact that this stream continues, like if I do hit this button, it's going to keep scrolling. Just give it a sec. Yeah, there you go. Another chunk. Know that this is Google. If I wanted like a final verification, what I can do is pull up my command prompt. And I can go just do a CLS. I'm going to do NSLOOKUP on 173.194.31.71. And I believe this belongs to Google, but let me do one last check here. I'm going to do IP lookup. I'm going to plug this in. And yes, that's a Google IP. So I'm fairly confident now that that is actually my YouTube traffic. I'm going to go back. And without changing this filter, what I'm going to do is going to go to Analyze, or Statistics, sorry, IO Graphs. Now, an IO graph is really a graph that you can customize in Wireshark to show you different statistics based on filters. Now, you'll notice something that you already see some data graphed. We need to just edit this a little bit to make sure it's exactly what we want, because you can see there's a whole bunch of different filters selected. So what I want to make sure of is that I'm using only the filter that relates to my traffic. In this case, the IP address is 10.0.10.43 and 173.194.31.71. If I wasn't certain what that was, I could actually go back and just find that IP again and match it up. But Wireshark is already taking the filter that is in your display filter box here, and actually turning that into an IO graph filter. I just want to turn off everything else. So I'm going to take this off, this off, this off, and this off. So right away, you can start seeing something pretty cool, which is a graph showing these little spikes of data, right? And are spikes of data transfer. The units right now are in packets per 1 second. Now, packets are interesting, especially if you're in networking and need to understand packets per second. I'm more interested in bits per second, so actual data. So I'm going to click on the y-axis field and select packets. I'm going to change this to bits. Okay, let that load. You can see here my y-axis has changed to bits per second. So this is showing me a few things. One, it's actually showing me that just like we talked about before, the data is actually downloaded in chunks. Okay, so there's like a chunk of data downloaded here, a lot of activity, and then nothing. And then a lot of activity and nothing. This is opposed to what some people may believe, which is that if you're downloading like a 1080p stream, you know, the bit rate's going to be at a certain level. And if you're downloading a 4K stream, it's going to be at a different level, etc. So the chunking is very visible here. If we want to get an estimate of sort of what that maximum bit rate is when the chunk is downloaded, we can extrapolate a little bit from the left-hand side. So say it's right around here, 1 times 10 to the 7. This is scientific notation. So that's 10 million bits per second. Okay, so 10 million bits per second is... I'm going to need to do some mental math. So that's 10 million bits, 10, divided by 1,000 bits in a kilobit. It's 10,000 kilobits per second divided by, that's 10 megabits around there, okay? So you can get a sense of how much of your bandwidth, say this is your internet pipe, or it's going through your internet pipe, how much of your bandwidth is taken up by downloading this video, okay? So it's not a constant 10 megabits per second. It's bursts of it that go, you know, some of them are a little bit below, some of them are a little bit above, okay. All right? Now, let's see what happens finally when we get to a higher quality video. So I'm going to open up YouTube one last time. And I'm going to open up, I'm going to go back. I'm gonna look for a 4K or 8K video UHD. I'm gonna click on that. And I'm gonna let it play. Now, it may not be connected to the same IP, so I'm just gonna see whether or not this stream continues. If not, I'll go back and do the same analysis. Now, keep in mind that we had the burst up to about 10 megabits with this video we had before, okay? Now, let's looks like it stopped, so I'm gonna close this conversation. It's got some nice dolphins here. I'm gonna open up Wireshark again. My conversation view is open again, and I wanna see whether or not there's another conversation that is now taken over. It looks like, let's see. Let's get a, this one is a relatively long duration. So let's get a clean capture. Let's do this. Let's close this off and let's restart. Let's clear this filter. Let's let it run. Let's do conversations. And then I'm going to do the same thing I did before. So now I can see again my webcam here. But I can see this other conversation that I'm suspecting is actually the one that is taking this traffic. So let me just apply this filter, select it, AB. It is also quick. As you can see, it's UDP. And the packet sizes resemble quick. Let's go to statistics, IO graph. Let's now we see our filters here. And the IP address matches what we saw in conversations. Let's take off the old one. This is the old one we didn't want from before. And let's change this to bits. Let's observe. And this is bits per second. So interestingly enough, the spikes on a what looks to be an ultra 4K video, in terms of actual throughput, or bitrate looked to be not too much higher than what we had for that other video, which is pretty interesting. Now, the amount of data downloaded in that spike is likely going to be more, right, to accommodate the fact that there's more data in a 4K or 8K stream than there is in a lower quality stream, but the spikes look relatively similar. So this is pretty interesting. There's also a pretty large gap in time between one chunk and the other. Presumably, you get enough data in this so that you don't have to actually download again. So this technique, we're doing it with Google or with YouTube. And YouTube has this nice function to show you some other stats as well. But this works with other streaming sites as well, right? You can use this with Instagram or other sites that where you download videos from. And just take a look at how they're downloaded, what IPs they're getting the data is coming from, and then what pattern looks like. So you can make an actual assessment of how much bandwidth is needed to download this video. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions on the topic we've covered, please join the Discord server where we talk all things network. Until next time.